Welcome to my presentation on methods and parameterization for modeling flow-based market coupling using our power market tool named POMATO, which is joint work with my colleague Robert Mead within the Modezin project. POMATO was written to synthesize the flow-based market coupling process, and therefore to motivate this research, I want to present the current state and challenges of the European market and its transition towards a more sustainable future. I want to briefly illustrate the modeling process of flow-based market coupling and then focus on POMATO itself and highlight the main components, market model and redundancy removal, that are written in Julia and relying on jump capabilities. To give an example use case, I want to highlight our latest work, which is work in progress, where we use the risk-aware formulation of the market model using chance constraints to model flow reliability margins within flow-based market coupling. Let's start with the motivation, which comes from modeling zonal electricity markets and their means for capacity allocation and congestion management. The method of capacity allocation, meaning the allocation of commercial exchange capacities, was until 2015 done using static net transfer capacities, which come with a specific set of problems. Namely, the lack of clear method means that the process itself is intransparent, and they are often overly conservative, while at the same time, they do not account for zone internal network elements. In 2015, the capacity allocation by NTC was replaced as the preferred method by flow-based market coupling, which comes with a new set of solutions, mainly the ability to include individual network elements in the process of capacity allocation, but also plenty of problems and questions because of its complexity and lack of publicly available resources or knowledge. Flow-based market coupling is a multi-stage process coordinated by the TSOs, which involves detailed zone-specific net load and generation forecasts and network models, which are not only partially disclosed by the TSOs. Specifically, this three-step process consisting of a D-2 capacity forecast, also known as base case, which represents the best estimate of the system state at point of delivery. Based on this forecast, so-called flow-based parameters are calculated and used to constrain the commercial exchange capacities in the day-ahead market stage. Lastly, D-0 stage consists of intraday adjustment and congestion management, meaning the physical delivery. Academic publications steadily become more plentiful, and generally there's a consensus on the modeling process that follows the three steps, D-2, D-1, D-0, akin to the real process, utilizing an economic dispatch problem at every step. While central to the European electricity market, flow-based market coupling is still new, and many issues that will arise in the short and midterm are still not addressed or very well discussed. Those are, among others, the extension to the core region, the effect of minimum trading capacities in the flow-based market coupling process, or changes in bidding zone configurations. POMATO aims to facilitate these discussions and provides an open model that can support the required flexibility regarding network representation only using open methods and data. Some of the main features and contributions are separation of data management, which is implemented in Python, and optimization, which is implemented in Julia, to achieve a flexible Python-based user interface that is familiar to many users while creating a lean and performant implementation of the central optimization model in the well-readable jump algebraic modeling language. This is depicted in the figure on the left. For this talk, I want to focus on the Julia components, which provide the main functionality, or in other words, the heavy lifting. Additionally, POMATO can solve stochastic OPF using chance constraints to analyze the impact of forecast errors from renewable energy sources, which is our current research, and I will present some results as the application. But let's talk more about the two components. First, the market model, which is used to solve each step in the flow-based market coupling process, as seen on the right. This economic dispatch problem can be formulated in a very general way, as seen in equations 1, which finds the most cost-effective allocation of generation capacities to meet demand, subject to capacity curtailment and storage constraints. Depending on the step in the flow-based process, equations 1 can be subject to transport constraints, which enforce limits on individual lines based on nodal power injections or net positions, here depicted in 2A or 2B, or enforce static limits like net transfer capacities on commercial exchange in 2C. Given we solve the same problem subject to different network representation, Julia jump provides the necessary flexibility to set up a performance solution, but remains readable and maintainable. The second part of POMATO I want to highlight is the redundancy removal algorithm. Linear power flow calculations often are formulated using power transfer distribution factor matrices, which form a system of linear inequalities that define feasible region for nodal power injections, especially when considering contingencies, meaning unplanned outages. It has been shown that, in fact, most of these constraints are redundant, meaning that they are never binding in the optimal solution due to the existence of a more restrictive constraint. This redundancy removal identifies these non-redundant set of constraints, which is visualized in the figure in the middle. Its implementation and performance has been presented in our previous work, where we showed that for different real-life datasets, over 99% of the constraints can be removed from the optimization problem without changing the feasible region of the power flow and, in extension, the optimal solution. Both models are utilized in our latest research effort, where we model flow reliability margins that are used in the real world to cover the impact of uncertainty on individual network elements in the flow-based process. This is done by reformulating the previously shown dispatch problem to account for uncertain feed-in from intermittent generation and the corresponding response of dispatchable generators. This is implemented using chance constraints that can be formulated as second-order cones. This results in security margins reserved on network elements and the ability to freely choose a solver that can handle second-order conic constraints makes this a trivial exercise, and all network constraints that are used in this model are pre-solved using the redundancy removal algorithm to significantly reduce the number of constraints and second-order conic constraints in the model. As a result, we can see a so-called flow-based domain depicted in the figure on the left that visualizes the available commercial exchange capacities given to the market. The right figure includes the reliability margins depicted in blue, which reduce the line capacity in relation to the impact of uncertainty of renewable generation. And due to the reduced exchange capacities, we can see an increase in system costs. However, we can also show that the result is more robust against forecast errors. This is shown in the bottom figure, where the range of costs for hourly congestion management is significantly lower for introduced errors using the chance constraint formulation, which is depicted in red. I hope this provided a useful introduction on how we use Julia Jump in our electricity market model. Our main contribution is that we provide means to study the process and develop efficient parameterization or do policy relevant studies. This explicitly includes the data site, where we have a separate repository that allows to assemble POMATO compatible data set from other great open source resources. Here are the main three publications related to the model, with the fourth one hopefully available as a preprint at the time of this conference. This is everything from my side, and I'm happy to answer any questions.